While working at NW Air, he developed an award-winning modernist style, influenced by the work of Paul Rand that focused on the visual organization of structural forms. Up until this point, he had been trained as a painter and was specifically hired because of the paintings in his portfolio. Adding modernist principles to his perspective allowed him to become more well-rounded. His work at NW Air eventually landed him an opportunity to take over the art department at Columbia Records. There, he used his sensibility to pioneer the use of imaginative album art by combining typography with his paintings. Of his time there, he said, "When I got to Columbia, there was the beginning of some idea of album cover art, but it was still just type and maybe a photo of the artist that was arranged in an interesting way. I think that I was the first to use painters, photographers, and illustrators to do artwork on album covers." He eventually left Columbia to start his own studio and expand his portfolio. Be that as it may, the novelty of the work he did at Columbia has granted him the classification as an avant-garde designer who sought to push the boundaries of convention. He believed he was fortunate to have been able to spend time as a designer before the age of the computer, because he had to, as he put it, find solutions with his own hands rather than rely so heavily on technology.